Jacks.com. I love my life. Mr. Phil Laak. Phil, good to see you.
Good seeing you, sir.
This is your good hand.
Yes.
How's it going with this one?
Well, I brought this for my backpack to show you what I'm going through. The bone healed right, but I basically suffered some muscular atrophy. Nothing that the body can't overcome. But instead of just being normal, I have to do 5 times a day. An hour a day. I generally do it like 10 hours a day. I'm just stretching, whatever. And hopefully within a year, I'll have you. See, I have all these exercises, pages of exercises. Same. After the accident, right when I was laying in the desert, I'd given a net worth for that moment not to have happened, and then just rebuild. Whatever. Building's fun anyways, you know? And so I love it. I'm getting my body back, and I didn't have to give my net worth to get it back, you know, so it's like kind of cool. So yeah, life is good. My only regret is we all have a certain battery life, like whatever, 80, 100 years. What a magical thing if you could be a Highlander or a vampire. I mean, vampire maybe not so much because you have to eliminate other humans to keep alive. But what to be a Highlander? All you have to do is fight another Highlander every couple of years, and if you lose your head, you're done. But imagine how long their lifespans were.
Wow.
So we're all connected. It's like we're almost like grass, in a sense that grass is on a lawn. We're grass to earth, but we have consciousness. So we're like little blades of grass moving around, but instead of just getting cut by somebody, like to mate or whatever, to let it grow wild, we can stand up our little blade and walk over to another area and build like a little road or whatever. It's like crazy. This is a total ramble. Edit this as you will.
Go.
It's funny, in the olden days, I would play the tournaments after I built the money up from a cash game, because I was just like so realizing the lottery aspect of the tournaments. And then I said about 2 years ago, I became lazy, you know. And so this time I played the 5K and the 10K, bust. I said, okay, let me just try and go back to my semi-old school and make the money back. So it feels good, working the tables, old school, you know. Man, it's nice because a lot of the old school guys, Lee Markholt, he's an old schooler, and he pounds the games. Then there's the new old schoolers, like the internet guys that are actually live game players first in their heart, but they learned online. Like Eric Liu, to me, I love when he's in the cash game. He's there all the time. And he could be online, right? But he's here. He's here a lot. And there's other guys like that, like Vivek. He likes to show up. There's some people, because poker's a social game, and once you start playing live, I don't care what they say, it's so much better than online. You have the world around you, and funny things happen, and social, and whatever. So, yeah, there's a lot of them out tonight, but this trip, mostly they weren't around. And I was like, why? Well, I'm the only guy, like, it was like, see, there's a lot of young internet smart guys, but the old schoolers, there wasn't many of the old schoolers, the guys that played cards 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
All of them apparently got rich, and they're all, like, sitting back on boats and stuff, and I'm still working because I never got rich. Yeah, so you got to edit this, make it a show.
No, we're going to feature the whole thing. Phil.
I love Marco. He's the best, you know.
Phil, I got to point this out to you.
Yeah.
We're standing at a place.
Blitz. We made a damn blitz sighting. That's great. Do you know what that means?
Blitz?
Now, see, as an old school pro, this is a thing that a lot of people don't get. Dan, by the way, people underestimate him. He knows how to play. At the beginning, he didn't. So when he sits down, other people, frenetic buttons go start haywire and stuff. So you want to be in a game with blitz, even though he might be squeezing, because other people lose their mind. He has that look, and he's also very entertaining, very funny, very aggressive with some of his lines of communication, almost a little bit too much, and certainly in the company of women or people with sensitive sensibilities, should stay away from blitz, I'll tell you that. But if you're like a degen that wants a show, then you want the blitz table. So I see he's roaming around. He's at the desk. He's scratching. He's like,
we can hail his attention in some way.
No, that's not, you know.
Okay.
You got to let the wild beast roam, you know. He's like a lion, what do you call it, a bear in the woods. He's got the thing.
Is he shitting? I don't know. This is a historical spot where we're standing right now.
I love that. That's where the governor. The
right
governor. Bread and butter.
Bread and butter.
That's where he was, right there.
You're not offended by any of that stuff, because I shushed him because you were sitting right there.
That's what life's all about, is the random, like, texture. You just want to live in a slippery, flat, white world with simple texture walls and just be bored out of your mind, or do you want bread and butter, guys? I want bread and butter, you know. I want the edges. I live for edges, you know. I want to be on them and look at them.
You're a different man after the Enduro thing, eh?
I am super duper, oh wow, yeah, that was the point of this whole, I am an improved human. I play better poker, I'm more patient. I, before the injury, was beating people in racquetball I'd never beat before. I was crying in spots in movies where I wouldn't normally cry. I saw the travesty of nature that British Petroleum caused to the birds with the oil on them. Yeah. Before that, I would have said, what a travesty, whatever, but I wouldn't cry. Yes, I weeped for the birds. It was amazing. I felt, there was one time where I weeped because of something on TV, and I was in a gym, and there was people around. Then I weeped in happiness, cried, whatever, that I wasn't embarrassed by the fact that I was like, what is going on? This is great. It felt like, you know, like when I was in college, and I realized, wow, embarrassment is such like a wasted emotion, and I worked so hard to rid myself of embarrassment by putting myself forcibly into embarrassing situations, thinking that that would solve it. It didn't. I was always embarrassed. Like, if you walk naked through the quad, you're just going to be embarrassed. You can't get out of that. But something about staying awake for 115 hours releases, makes something, maybe new pathways, neuron created by serotonin high or something. So maybe I have neurotonins in me or something. That's what I was trying to say. But I mean, it took a long time. Maybe I didn't know it. I don't know what I'm saying. I'm just saying, you know.
Just a minute now.